Hello and welcome to Pembroke Bach-a-thon Virtual Edition. That's better. I'm delighted to be offering some pieces from the basement of my family's home in Sheffield. I started learning the organ as a chorister in the Anglican Cathedral, which is 3 miles as the Kakapo flies in that direction. Or if Kakapo's a flight, but anyway. This is the practice instrument that got me through Cambridge organ trials, ARCO, FRCO, entry into postgraduate study at the Royal Academy of Music. So as you can imagine, hours of sweat, blood and tears. I've given it a wipe down so it looks a bit more presentable. But there you have it. It's a Renaissance Quantum, rather bafflingly named, by Allen Q300 model for those who are interested in such things. We have some variable voices which involved auditioning literally 100 quintadinas to find the one. So that's going to make an appearance liberally all over these pieces. Speaking of Cambridge organ trials, the first piece I'm going to share with you is the Trio Sonata No. 1 in E-flat. Now, like many of my colleagues who went through the process of auditioning for organ scholarships at Cambridge using the first movement, I haven't touched it since the audition, and so I was pleasantly surprised when, by the simple act of turning a page, I discovered that there's a ravishing second movement, really gorgeous. The quintadina is going to make an appearance in that, certainly, alongside some other 8-foot pitches. And then we have the actually rather cheeky, sprightly last movement to round it off, using all the high mutations I could find, because life's too short for 8-4-2, if I'm going to be honest. Next up, we have the short, the first of the three Kyries from Klavierübung Part 3. We have the melody in the soprano in long notes, a little bit of ornamentation, but it's suitably austere and penitential, stile antico, old-style counterpoint in the lower voices. Then, finally, to round off, I'm offering two chorale preludes from the Neumeister collection. These were new to me, so thank you, Anna, for introducing me to these pieces. The first one is Werde munter meine Gemüter, an evening hymn, and yet quite sprightly, because the first line means be alert, O my soul, it's not quite time to go to bed yet. So quite a sprightly setting by Bach. It's got this quirky triplet-y section in the middle. And in order to give that light, airy feel, I'm using the 4-foot flutes altogether. And finally, Nun freut euch, Christians, rejoice, one and all, including you, you, and you. And this is normally played manualiter, but I'm doing a version as a trio, which allows me to solo out the chorale melody as a kind of terrible duck of 8-foot reeds in the pedal. And we'll have the quintadina again with a string as the bass. And finally, to add some glitter on top, a gap registration of 8-4 and the quinflute 1 1/3, which is quite lovely, for the right hand. Now remember, this isn't just about Bach as wonderful as he is. This event is to raise money for the charitable work that Pembroke College does for children in Zambia. So if you feel moved to give a donation, the link is in the video description. Thanks for tuning in. Thank you.
Hello and welcome to the Norman Church of St. Peter's in Petersfield, Hampshire. My name is Mark Dancer and I'm Director of Music here. I shall be playing four works by Bach for you on the Lammermuir organ. The organ dates from 1991 and was overhauled and given a new piston system in 2013. The key action is tracker throughout. It is unusual in that the lowest keyboard is a coupler manual. There is no swell to great draw stop. The works I'm about to play are as follows. First, the Fantasia con imitazione, BWV 563. This is effectively a short prelude and fugue in the key of B minor and slightly old-fashioned in its idiom. Next comes a very short chorale prelude, Herr Jesu Christ dich zu uns wendt, BWV 726. This consists of a harmonisation of each of the four phrases of the melody, linked by demi-semiquaver flourishes. The last phrase in particular contains a remarkable chromatic progression. The last two works are the two settings of Fallet will ich dir geben, BWV 735 and 736. Both are strongly imitative in their construction, with the chorale melody in the pedals. But there the similarity stops. I shall let the music speak for itself.
Thank you. Hello to all. I am Jillian Gardner, the Director of Music and Organist here at Huntsville First United Methodist Church in Huntsville, Alabama. The organ I am playing is a 41-rank Shantz from 1961 with 56 ranks of Walker Digital that were added in 2008. In my program today, we will visit some chorales and trios of Bach, including chorales from the Klavierübung 3, the Neumeister Collection, and Trio Sonata No. 6.
Thank you. Hello and welcome to Christchurch Cathedral here in Oxford in the United Kingdom. My name is Benjamin Sheen and I'm the current sub-organist here at Christchurch. It gives me great pleasure to present a short recital for you today on the beautiful Riga organ that you can see behind me. I'll be playing three works. Firstly, the fugue on a theme by Corelli, which takes as its fugue subject a theme originally from a trio for two violins and cello by Corelli. Then a short Neumeister chorale entitled Vascot Tut, Das ist Wohlgetan, and ending with the C major prelude and fugue BWV 547, often referred to as the 9-8 prelude and fugue. It's my great pleasure to be part of this Bach-a-thon alongside friends and colleagues from across the world, all coming together to support this extremely worthy cause. The Muse Trust provides both educational and financial support to many children and families across Zambia. And I would encourage you to be as generous as possible, as I know firsthand what an amazing foundation this is in supporting those who need it most. Please give generously, and thank you in advance from all of us here. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, my name's Tom Dilley. I'm currently organ scholar at the Queen's College, Oxford, and originally from St. Albans. For the Bach 24-hour live stream, I'll be using a Hauptwerk sample set on a digital instrument due to current circumstances. And I'll be playing four of Bach's chorale preludes. So the first two are from the Great 18 Leipzig collection, followed by Bach's unique setting of Erbarm dich mein, and concluding with one of his earliest chorale settings from the Neumeister collection. Thanks again to Anna Lapwood for organising this event, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Michael Hay, and I serve as the Associate Director of Music and Organist here at St. Patrick's Cathedral in New York City. Christiana Liberis is playing violin with me for this Bach Marathon. We're happy to be playing organ works, not really organ works actually, works that aren't for organ, but played on organ, of Bach. We'll be playing the Bach E Major Violin Concerto, BWV 1042, which is originally for violin, solo, and orchestra. And I'll also be joining with the Well-Tempered Clavier Prelude and Fugue in C-sharp minor, which ends in a five-voice triple fugue. It's a very complex piece of music, and although it's not written for organ, it's written for clavier, whatever that may be, harpsichord, piano, and whatnot. I've adapted both of these works to the organ. So it's an unusual pairing, violin and organ, but it certainly is fun and it works quite well in my opinion. We're happy to be joining as part of the 24-hour Bach Marathon, using the lush sounds of this 1930 Kilgan organ that we have here at St. Patrick's. So we hope you enjoy our program, and we're so happy to be able to be a part of this.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Peter Douglas, and I am organist at First Presbyterian Church in Muncie, Indiana, United States. I am performing on the Opus 16 of Golding and Wood organ, 1990. The organ has 63 ranks, 6 divisions, and 3 manuals. There are 3 Bach organ works that I will be playing for you. First is Aus tiefer Not schrei ich zu dir, BWV 687, which translates to Out of the Depths I Cry to Thee, a paraphrase of Psalm 130. This simple setting uses the chorale melody in long notes and the soprano over free counterpoint. Second is Wenn wir in höchsten Noten sein, BWV 641. This chorale prelude comes from Das Orgelbüchlein, and the title translates to When in the Hour of Utmost Need. It features a very ornate chorale melody in the right hand. Third and finally is Canzona in D minor, BWV 588. Bach harkens back to older forms with this piece, looking to the keyboard music of Italy with composers such as Frescobaldi. The piece is in 2 parts, each being a strict fugue. I am honored to be a part of this project, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Hello and welcome. I'm Dr. Wyatt Smith, and I'm coming to you today from Epiphany Parish of Seattle, here in the gorgeous Pacific Northwest of the United States, where I am the Associate Director of Music. I will be playing this organ by Fritz Nowak, built in 1997, featuring three manuals, 36 stops, and 47 ranks. I will be sharing 8 works of Bach, starting with a great prelude and fugue in G major, followed then by a delightful chorale prelude on Allein Gott in der Höhe sei er, featuring the gorgeous 4-foot flute of the great. This will then be followed by a selection of from the Schubler chorales, Wir nur den lieben Gott. Then we will hear 3 selections from the Orgelbuchlein. First, Jesu meine Freude, and then the 2 settings of Liebster Jesu, wir sind hier. I will close the program with 2 selections from Klavierübung dritter Teil. First, the large setting of Christe aller Welt Trost, and then the great setting of Aus tiefer Not in 6 voices. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Hello everybody. My name is Dominique Weidig. I am from Germany. And I take part in the Bach-a-thon by Anna Lapwood. At first, I want to introduce you to this organ where I am at the moment. This organ is built by Walker in 1972. It has 23 stops. And it's pretty much one of the beautiful organs we have here in the in this countryside. Basically, this organ is located in Zurich in Germany, and I am the church organist there, something like the titular organist. Well, I want to tell you something about my repertoire. I play from Bach out of the 8 short preludes and fugues. I play number 1, number 7, and number 8, better known as BWV 553, prelude and fugue in C major, BWV 559, prelude and fugue in A minor, and BWV 560, prelude and fugue in B flat major, I'm sorry. These are the first three pieces I've learned in my current organ playing career. The BWV 553, the prelude and fugue in C major, I've learned from about 4.5 years ago, I guess. It's one of the most beautiful pieces I've played by Bach, and I really, really like it to play, and I enjoy it. Every note I play from my heart. Today we are taking the Bach-a-thon by Anna Lapwood. I'm very, very thankful and happy that I can take part in and be part of it. And yeah, I hope you enjoy my playing. And well, the last thing I can say, enjoy, have fun, and a beautiful time. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Hello, my name is James Wetzel, and I am the Director of Music and Organist at the Dominican Church of St. Vincent Ferrer on Manhattan's Upper East Side. Our 1918 landmark building, designed by Bertram Goodhue in the French Gothic style, houses two organs built by the Shantz Organ Company of Orville, Ohio, in the American classical style, an 18-rank chancel organ and a 68-rank gallery organ that you will be hearing today. For my part of this Bach-a-thon, I will be offering his Prelude and Fugue in D minor, BWV 538, commonly known as the Dorian. And in between the Prelude and Fugue, I will be presenting five of Bach's organ chorale preludes, two from the Easter section of the Orgelbüchlein and three independent chorales. I hope you enjoy.